for allowing us an opportunity that the NMBC have a brothers here at the Mosque Cares Convention. Let me say we are grateful and thankful to Allah for working together, coming together, trying to make things happen, trying to move forth, because we understand that in order to be able to get where we need to go, and as the Brother Wallace reminded me, it costs. Nice breakfast you eating, halal, lights, nice tables, chairs, that's cost. And we know that we thank you for really responding. And we have youth here this morning. Have the Imam from out of New York that's bought the youth up to this breakfast. Alhamdulillah. Takbir. Brothers and sisters, it's about the youth. What do you think it's about? You think it's about me? 65, 70, 80 years old, you think it's about me? It's not going about you? It's about these brothers and sisters that's sitting behind us. This is what it's about. We're talking 50 years from now. And if we don't train them like they supposed to be, and entrepreneurs and doing what they necessarily need to do, we won't have no mosques, we won't have no NMBC, we won't have anything that we've been working for 75 years. This is what it's about. All my emphasis on the youth. My children, children, your children. This is my pledge I made years ago with the leader, Imam Wafidin Muhammad, Allah forgive me for sins, granted in paradise. This is what I made to his son as well. This is the direction we are moving into. The Imam told me, and I'll never forget it, when we was in Kansas City. He said, Brother David, we just can't wait on folk. These are his words, I'm quoting him. And he said, we can't wait on those brothers and sisters. He said, we will send somebody back to get them.
That's right.
We have a mission to do. We have a work to do. And he said, no, we won't go get them. We'll send somebody back to get them because our mission and our work is more greater than worrying about a few folk.
That's right.
This is where we at, brothers and sisters. This is our youth. We're happy to see them there. But y'all take a stand, please, the youth. The future of tomorrow in science, math, economic development, et cetera, and et cetera. Allahu Akbar. Sister Joanne, where she's at? Alhamdulillah, she's in the hall, working sister, being communication. And the Imam is right there. Alhamdulillah. Imam is present. Ma'am ain't waiting for somewhere. He's present. Ma'am Abdullah. So brothers and sisters, we're going to get right into the meeting. I'm going to present to you our steering chairperson of NMBC, Sister Basima.
Thank you, Brother David. Assalamu alaikum. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The National Muslim Business Council welcomes you to our breakfast that we partner with Mosque Care. This business breakfast is an ongoing breakfast throughout our community, throughout all our associations and our organizations. But the special day is with Mosque Care, the convention that we all should be at and support every year. One of the things that I heard and was so eloquently said yesterday, that the Imam Wafidin Muhammad, may Allah be pleased with him, forgive him for his shortcomings. We should always support all the initiatives of Imam Wafidin. All the initiatives. So brothers and sisters, this convention is the first one that I remember that he asked us to support 100%. So please, when you go back to your cities, tell everybody what happened here, how you enjoyed yourself, what was good. I know you tell them what's bad, but let's eliminate that this time. Let's tell them all that was good and encourage them to come next year because we need your support. And you are our ambassadors for this convention and for our community. So when you think of Mosque Care, I want you to tell them And I want you to tell them about all the other initiatives that come with our community. So with that said, the National Muslim Business Council is another initiative Imam Warf Deen brought to us in his legacy, and he wants us to continue it. And our mission is to establish an association that will bring Muslim businesses and the general business community together into a collective entity. Our businesses, not the neighbor's businesses, not the other businesses in your community. We want to bring our businesses to develop a local partnership of networking services for the benefits of its memberships, to promote moral excellence in American business life. Now, who else can promote moral excellence than brothers that were brought up in the FOI, the sisters that were brought up in the MGT, the sisters and brothers that are following the life of the Prophet and following the Quran. To organize a business strategy to support Muslims in the state around the country and make investments in each other, to strengthen and share the responsibilities for community economic development and unification with an international perspective. Inshallah, that's our goal. One of the things that Imam Warf Deen left for us, out of the million things he left for us, this one has a special moment for right now. Right now, we're celebrating the 50th year of us becoming people that could actually sit in the front of the bus and not in the back of the bus. This year, we're talking about the promise that was kept, or should be kept. This year, Imam Warf Deen left us the best situation, and it's very appropriate for right now. So I quote, "The best situation we can have for ourselves right now is to pretend in great measure that there is no one to buy from and no one to sell to but ourselves. For what it is that is keeping us inferior now, African American brothers and sisters, we are building everybody else's business but our own. We are giving everybody else a market but ourselves. This is a big problem. No one spends money carelessly as do African Americans. We spend money like we do not want it, and as if it were a sin to have it. So if we were to start spending money more with each other, we would become wealthy people. It is said that the annual spending of the African American people is greater than the annual spending of a good-sized nation. We have the spending power of good-sized nations, but are not bent getting the benefits. It is because we give our market to everyone but to ourselves. That's shame. That is shame on us. Shame on us. And I'll say it again, shame on us. Thank you. I think the problem of entanglement of racial sentiments and this idea that we have to integrate physically and culturally is hurting us. We have been outmaneuvered, tricked to get into situations where we just dissipate all of our energies in much needless battles with the society. We should be concentrating on is establishing ourselves the whole life and following our own purpose. That purpose for us now is to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Muslims following the Quran, Allah's guidance, and the Prophet." Quote Imam W. D. Mohammed. Thank you.
Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you, Sister Basima. Alhamdulillah. Brothers and sisters, you just listened to the best situation by Lady Imam Warf Deen Muhammad. I mean, we're ahead. What are we waiting on? Are we waiting on someone else? Or we take up responsibility?